Hey, sports card collectors and investors, how's everybody doing? It is Tuesday. We have made it. Tomorrow we have the NBA draft. I'm excited to talk about basketball cards today. This is going to be a fun one. But first, before we get into all of that, if you have not subscribed, please subscribe. Karate chop the like button. Try to do something different. Everyone always says smash or punch or whatever. Karate kick the like. Kick it or punch it or elbow it. The like button is important. We need it. We need you guys. And hey, this channel, if you're new here, we talk all things collectibles, personal finance. We talk a lot about sports cards, graded video games, graded action figures, all the fun stuff, all the good stuff, guys. It's all right here on this channel. So if you have not subscribed yet, please do so. We have daily videos that come out. Also, please check the video description for my email subscription. Sign up for that. And then also links to all my social media accounts. We're all down there, Instagram, Twitter. Let's mix it up everywhere, guys. I want to talk to you on all platforms, so let's connect. All right, today I'm talking about why I'm investing in basketball cards. And first off, it's just fun. Let's just start off with that. It's really, really fun. I do also invest in traditional investments like stocks, bonds, real estate, etc. But alternative investments can be very fun, and collectibles have a lot of potential to buy and sell. One thing that's great about basketball cards is you can get in. There's all sorts of different entry points depending on your strategy. So there's kind of, there's a few different buckets. There's probably a variety of buckets, but just to break it down into three main ones, you can invest in new rookies coming into the league. So, you know, guys that are just coming in, or maybe second year players as well that didn't get a lot of playing time as a rookie, but the expectation is that they're going to move up. And into more playing time, etc. That's big time speculation. Obviously, that's going to be more risky, but that can be fun if you are big into basketball statistics and you want to kind of be right on some of these guys. Now, look, if you're going that route, you know, a lot of times you're going to be wrong, and you just have to accept that, you know. But maybe those guys eventually do get playing time years down the road, and you can still do well on those cards. But you just have to understand that if you're speculating on brand new players, you might have to be patient, and you also have to really look for value and probably make sure to stick to sets that are very popular. If they are not well-known rookies, stick with Prism product would be what I would do. I would stick strictly with Prism, just because even though Prism is very expensive and in demand, those players presumably will not be as expensive just because they're not as well known, not getting the playing time, etc. The next bucket would be established players, kind of that middle tier of guys that are really in the thick of things. You know, it's guys like Giannis. It's guys like, I think you could probably put Luka into this box now, even though he's only been in a couple of years. He showed enough to be in kind of this bucket. You know, the Jamal Murrays, the Dame Lillards, the list goes on and on of these guys that are just trying to get over the hump. You know, Anthony Davis was in this bucket. Now he has gotten over the hump with a championship. So he's kind of really solidified himself a little bit more. There's that middle bucket of guys that are really, really exciting, kind of that mid-level, not a super veteran, not a rookie, just right in between. And so that's another bucket to focus on. And that can be a lot of fun too. There's a lot of volatility with those guys, but at least you kind of know, all right, they belong here in the league. They're getting playing time. They're a star on their team, or the second guy on their team that's a star. Next would be the Hall of Fame players. And this can be active. I would say maybe four buckets. So the active players that are future Hall of Famers. This is the LeBron James, the Steph Currys, the Kevin Durants. You know, those are guys that have already established themselves in the league. Now, to be fair, the prices are going to show that, though, too. So, you know, as you're looking to get into investing in basketball cards, you have these different tranches, and there's all these different price points. There's very, very expensive price points if we're talking about LeBron and Kevin Durant. You know, look, we saw a LeBron RPA sell for almost $2 million. So now that's kind of the very top of the market, but it gives you an idea of that's an active player, you know, and where those things can go for really, really scarce cards. And that fourth bucket, I would call it vintage Hall of Famers, guys that are already out of the league. And this can be whether you're talking about basketball cards or football or baseball cards. These are very popular. Not as popular for those that are looking for that volatility, because typically vintage doesn't have as much volatility. But, you know, it is a lot of fun, though, because you already know, these are already established players. So these are the legends. you know, and so it can be very fun to go back and get those rookie cards for those folks. And those could be for the nostalgia side of it, for people that are getting back into the hobby, these could be cards that you maybe didn't really, couldn't afford them before. Now you've got some disposable income and you really want that Mickey Mantle card, or you want the Lou Alcindor card, or you want the Jim Brown rookie card, etc. There's all sorts. So whether you're, you know, the newer guys like a Trey Young, if you want to go vintage, you know, there's modern options or ultra modern options. And then if you want to go vintage, you know, I've got here just as examples, Daryl Dawkins rookie. This is a 70s card, 77. Also another 70s card, just barely. Tall Boy, 1970 Topps Pete Maravich rookie card. So you can go all over the place with it, and that's what makes it so fun. A lot of folks, though, you have longtime collectors that really do a lot of the vintage stuff, but a lot of people really like the volatility that comes with basketball cards, and there is kind of a sports betting element to this, fantasy sports type element to this. And to me, it's like, look, if you're into sports betting, if you're into fantasy sports, why not diversify into sports cards? I mean, if you look at, you know, if you're betting on sports, maybe you do like that rush of like, hey, if I'm right and this team wins, I make X amount. Or in fantasy sports, you know, you're doing, you know, DraftKings or FanDuel or something, you know, and if this works out. But I've done some of that stuff too, and I lose more than I win. It's tough to win those weekly fantasy deals, and it's easy to, you know, to get caught up in it, and it's gambling. Now look, sports cards is also speculating, it's gambling, like with really all investments, but at least you have something tangible there. You know, if the team loses when you're sports betting, you're out that money. If you do fantasy sports and you don't win, you're out that money. In most cases, unless there's just fantasy sports stuff I'm not aware of to where it carries over or something, I don't know. But sports cards give you something tangible, and even if you pick a player that doesn't have a great season, let's say you picked Trae Young because you're like, you know what, Trae Young is the next Steph Curry. Hawks are going to they're winning a title this year. They're going to shock the world. At least if it doesn't happen this season, Trae Young still can have a career and have something moving forward. Injuries are always a thing that we have to be concerned about with all athletes, of course, but you know, at least you've got something there to fall back on. It still can increase in value over time. So if you're into sports betting, or you're into fantasy football or fantasy sports in general, take a look at sports cards. You have to. Basketball cards are at an all-time high in demand globally. It's global, so you can sell them, you know, globally. There's a lot of, you know, great collectors all over the world for these. The demand is high. I believe it's on par with baseball cards, if not higher, especially with new product. New basketball product just flies off the shelves. So, you know, there's an insane amount of demand for basketball cards, and basketball as a sport, I think with the talent gap really tightening up in the league, it's kind of an anyone can win. You know, I know LeBron and the Lakers are, you know, were kind of that favorite, but how many more years does LeBron have in the league? And then you have that next, you know, you have that next set of guys coming up, and there's a lot of great players coming up. So that's what makes basketball cards and speculating on basketball cards really, really fun. How to get started? Pick a strategy. I mentioned that we've got kind of different tranches. Do you want to diversify between the tranches of, you know, brand new players, semi-established players, vintage players? You know, do you want to kind of diversify with all of those? Do you want to go heavy into one segment and then maybe flip cards and build up? Also, it depends too on your budget. You know, are you coming in with $1 million and you've got different strategies with that? Or are you going to need to buy and flip cards to be able to buy additional cards? And so with that, you have to be incredibly strategic in what you're doing. So, you know, we've got many, many videos on this channel about different ways to attack it, but this was just kind of one of those kind of, I wanted to talk about just why I'm investing in basketball cards, some of the upsides of it, and then get your thoughts too from viewership. We'll make additional videos, of course, on this stuff, but let me know your thoughts. Are you investing in basketball cards? What are your thoughts long-term on basketball cards and sports cards as a whole? I'd like to hear it. Guys, if you have not subscribed yet, please do so. We have daily videos coming out, and we will keep them coming. Have a great day.